Jesus resurrected from the dead, that he won over Satan. And there's no way Satan can regain that thing. No, I don't think you understand. That's why our faith is weak. Because when life is facing you, you don't go in your own strength. You go to the enemy and say, wait a minute, I stand here as the righteousness of God in Jesus Christ. He has won it for me. Oh, hallelujah. I don't know what happened to you. You better shout. That's how breakthroughs happen. He comes with a chariot of praise. Get back for you everything Satan has stolen. Lord, we recover all this morning in Jesus' name. Hallelujah! It says forever. I remember years ago I got a hold of that last part of the Lord's Prayer. And you know, these enemies of the gospel, they have taken that out of the Bible. Check your NIV, those of you that read that stuff. They say now, when he says, for thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever. They say Jesus didn't say that. I just keep laughing because when God said my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, it's not only what we don't know, it's what has been stolen from us. That's why the Lord said whenever the word is sown, the enemy comes immediately to snatch it. And you have to continue to put it back in. Have to continue to put it back in. Remind yourself, Jesus won for me. Jesus overcame for me. Jesus prevailed for me. It doesn't matter how I feel. The victory is mine now. Hallelujah. If you receive the testimony from the altar, your shout will come roaring back. Your miracle will show up. The fire of God will fall on you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Right now, there are even some things you don't know how to claim, but you can claim it in tongues. You can start talking in tongues, Lord. Even what I don't know how to receive. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah. I'm telling you, his spirit is moving. I don't know what you feel, even though I know it's not a feeling, but there's a rain falling. I hope it has touched you. I hope it has quickened you. Hallelujah. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. We give you praise. Thank you for your miracles. Thank you for deliverance. Thank you for fire. Thank you that every dead thing is coming alive now. Thank you, Lord, for the refreshing of the Holy Spirit. Thank you for the rain of glory. Here's one more thing he quickened to my heart before we move on. I know that most people say I'm Apostle KG. I keep showing up no matter what. But you need to understand something. If it was by feelings, I won't show up. If it was by experiences, I won't show up. I show up by faith. Where did I get that from? I was reading my Bible. And the Bible says that these people that went before us, it said through faith, they subdued kingdoms. You say, me and my faith can overcome a government, an army, principalities, powers. That's why I show up when they don't expect me to show up. That's why you show when they don't expect you to show. That's why you lift up a praise when they don't think you should. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Listen to what he just told me to tell you. He said, many of us don't know that your faith is a treasure. You ought to celebrate that God gave you faith to cause impossibilities to become possible. For you to defeat every devil that has been ruling your generation, ruling in your family, every curse, every name that is named, it doesn't matter who they are. He said you need to thank God this morning for faith. Celebrate your faith. Don't be upset that you have to live by faith. That's your victory. That's your power. That's your miracle. Thank God this morning that you have faith in your heart. For all men have not faith, but God has given you faith. Faith for miracles. Faith for deliverance. Faith for breakthroughs. Hallelujah. Lord, we celebrate you. Thank you for giving us faith. Thank you for the power of faith. For this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith. Thank you for faith power in this house this morning. Thank you for faith miracles. Thank you for faith signs and wonders. Thank you for faith deliverances. Thank you, Lord, for every blessing you've already released by faith. Those that believe, receive it now by faith. In Jesus' name. Come on, give me a hallelujah. Come on, high five at least three people. Tell them I celebrate my victory by faith. Your victory by faith. In Jesus' name. Holy Spirit is in the realm of faith this morning, because everything I'm hearing from him, he's saying the same thing. He said, when you look at your neighbor this morning, what you are looking at is the victory of faith. They showed up regardless of what's going on. They are shouting no matter how they feel. It don't matter what happened this week. Faith overcame. Hey! And they came to the house. You are looking at victories right in front of you. To your right. To your left. Whether you were limping, you limped in here by faith. It don't matter how you felt, you showed up anyway. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We magnify your name. We exalt your holy name. So after the service, you should never feel discouraged or in any way not value the power of faith in your heart. Remember that God said to us, when Satan loses in a frontal attack, he will return to you as a snake. He will come to you and say, well, why are you going to church? Nothing is changing. Just stay at home. But you get up. You need to thank God that you got up. You put your faith. You are still in the number. And if God counts up his jewels this morning, he will put your name on the list as somebody walking by faith. And you came with a shout. I know I already have four sermons going concurrently. Now I want to add a fifth one this morning, right now. It's happening right now. Hallelujah. Because I started thinking about them lepers. They are sitting there and finally they looked at each other and said, why sit we here and die? People that quit don't know that they just started dying. People that don't get up don't know that they started, that they're already on their way to the grave. But when you get up, hallelujah. I thank God that all those years I was serving God and this year breakthrough, that I kept going. I kept getting up. I kept praising God. Hallelujah. I led worship and didn't have food to eat, but I still came. I didn't say, no. Let me wait until I get a breakthrough before I will lead worship. I didn't say I was part of the singers. No, I was the leader. But I didn't have food to eat. But I came anyway. And I was singing, Satan is under my feet. 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 That's the power of faith. That's why I don't care about naysayers and haters. I serve God hungry. I praise God hungry. I preached hungry. I sang hungry. That's why today I'm flying a jet. Because I kept going. What will your faith produce tomorrow? But more importantly, it settled me in my faith so I can look to the right and see what other people are doing. I said, bless them. But I know that what I have is sufficient for me. I thank God every day, Lord, I thank you. I am pleased with how you're taking care of me. I may not have everything I desire, but I know I'm happy with you. Hallelujah. I was telling my leaders that a life without covetousness is a miracle, where you are pleased with the way God is taking care of you. Then he will do greater. He will do greater. Now, I'm going to say this, then I'm done. Then we'll move on. Watch. I was exhorting you, and I was asking him in my heart, Lord, why am I saying all this? I didn't plan this. He said, there are so many destinies in this room that Satan is blocking. And you are releasing a word of faith to unblock every demonic hindrance. I said, something. Hey, something will break you loose. Let the gates open. We'll be right back. the good fight of faith. Fight it. Win it. I told you I left all my friends behind. Those that are still waiting to feel better before they shout. Those that are still waiting to see something before they believe that God has answered the prayers. I left them all behind. Hallelujah. Hey. Hey. If you believe what I'm telling you, that door will open. That door will open. And you walk out of that prison. You walk out of every satanic barricade. You will start possessing your possessions. The time is now, not tomorrow. The time is now, not tomorrow.
Beloved, isn't it wonderful to be in an atmosphere charged with the presence of God, charged with the glory? Wow, you see people just running. These are dignified people that would not ordinarily do that. But under the glory, we're just little children running around. Huh? And if you're still frozen and dry and dead, you would think this is fanatical. Because the power hasn't touched you. The glory hasn't touched you. Maybe you're one of the NIV readers where they went and took off, "For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory." These things belong to us because they belong to our Heavenly Father through Jesus Christ. All power on earth belongs to God, including the one Satan is exercising. It's the power of God being used in reverse. God never took the power he gave him at the beginning. So celebrate the glory. Be revived in this new year. We've given you his word. Let the glory empower you to get up. Hallelujah. You show up by faith, no matter how tough it is. No matter how you feel, get up, show up. Get up, shout. Get up, praise God. Get up, lift your hands. Isn't that what the book of Hebrews says? He said, lift up the hands that hang down and the feeble knees. In other words, get back in prayer. Get back in worship. Watch, he says, and make straight paths for your feet. In other words, that's how you make crooked things to work out. You lift up your hands in worship. You bend your knees in prayer before the Lord. And he will come and make the crooked path straight. Amen and amen. That's your destiny in this new year. I was saying in that exhortation that your faith is a treasure. Your faith is a treasure. All men do not have faith. That God gives you the measure of faith. The only reason it's not developed is because you haven't used it. You're afraid. You haven't used it because you're afraid of making a mistake. Or you're afraid of failing. Use your faith in this new year. Get up and show up even when you're discouraged. Get up and show up even when you are in doubt. Get up and show up. In Jesus' mighty name. This is the best time for you to set the tone for your new year. When you see a ministry like this where the glory is flowing, that's where to put your seed and expect things to change and expect miracles to happen. And expect God to intervene. Every year should be born by a seed to release the power of the kingdom of God. All the facilities are there for you to make this a brand new year. And put your covenant seed in the ground and expect the God of resurrection to show up in your life. Hey, God just said to me, this is your year to determine whether you're going to fly or crash and burn. This is a determinant year. It's 2023. Jesus said that, I'm trying to remember exactly. Yes, That's the prophecy about the Lord Jesus. He is set for either the going up of some or the falling down of the others. He said, this child, a sword shall pierce him, that the thoughts of many shall be revealed. These are the prophecies of Simeon that I'm trying to remember in the book of Luke. He's set for the rising and falling of many. That's what 2023 is about. It's either you're going to use your faith and go up, or you sit around talking and you crash and burn. It's a determinant year. It's a determinant year. Hallelujah. Are you ready? We are bringing you the goods. It's for you to drink of the fountain. It's for you to believe and receive. It's for you to act on it. In Jesus' name, the water is stirred. Jump in. The water is stirred. You will be blessed. Your obedience is the only thing necessary. Your action is the only thing necessary. Do it today. Call today, 770-994-3777. All of that is there in front of you. Act on it, and we will celebrate with you, because we are winning in this new year, and you must win too. Amen. God bless you. Bye-bye. When dead things come.